When you file your taxes, you tell the government about your income, cost of goods sold, and expenses over the course of a year. If the IRS decides to audit your company, it's crucial that what's in QuickBooks matches what you gave to the government. So basically, we never want these transactions, once they're reported to the government, to change. Closing dates are a way for you to ensure that change never happens to those transactions. In our case, we want to protect all of the data that took place in 2017. So, to set a closing date and protect those transactions, we open the gear icon and then choose Account and Settings. Closing date settings are found under the Advanced area in the Accounting section. Right here, let's close the books and then enter 12/31/2017. We set this as the closing date because this way, every transaction that occurs on this date and before will be protected. Right now, if we try to change a transaction that happens on or before this date, we'll receive a warning. But we can go through an additional safety measure by assigning a password. With this option, you can enter a password into QuickBooks, and you can keep it for yourself or only give it to those people who understand closing dates and the importance of maintaining the integrity of data that's been reported for tax purposes. Now let's save this and close our settings. Now, if you try to change a transaction with a date on or before the closing date, or enter a new transaction that has a date on or before the closing date, you receive this window that requires you to enter a password. Closing dates are a way for you to add an additional layer of security in your QuickBooks company file.